What's up, guys? Pittsburgh Weisschwartz back again with yet another Deck Tech. Today, we're going to talk about an oldie but a goodie. You might have seen this on some NA Nats popping lists. We're going to talk about Railgun today. One of my personal old school favorites. I got Andy with me today for some emotional support.
Hey, guys. I don't know anything about this deck, except I saw the show, but don't remember.
Well, you've played into it a couple everything. Times. Just a little bit.
I played into it a little bit. I remember a few things, yeah. Cool. The coolest Esper since Mob Psycho.
But yeah, here's the overall list. If you're just here for the list, definitely leave us a like on the way out. That really helps us out. We're trying to hit 1,000 subscribers so we can stream our locals every week. That'd be real cool if we could get there. But yeah, here's the full list, and I'm going to jump into the individual cards. So around the time that I built this list and threw this together and picked up some cards off Yuta and was like going around Japan when I was there picking up this list, I wanted to play Oversize because Oversize was just better than Runner at the time. But I picked up this promo. It's a two or fewer cards in stock, Gains for Gender Powers, 4K. We're running three of that, and then we're running two of the additional oversized, which is this Kuroko. And if you have one or fewer other characters, it gains 1,000 power in hand on court, the 3,500 hand on court, and then a 4K with two or less stock. We're running five oversizes as our field pluses.
That's just a big lolly.
Yep. Yeah. I mean, you know, is what it is. But yeah, just this instead of the free runner that you typically see in these lists, you just typically see four free runner. But oversized was just better positioned at that time. And I think it still is. I've whipped this deck a couple times, locals, and the oversized play is definitely still correct. So if you want to play this deck in 2021, I definitely recommend some combination of oversizes. We still need to fix for yellow, so the Kuroko is important. Moving on.
Yes, very important.
We got this other Kuroko, which is on play console, reveal top, long as it's an ESP or Saturn, add ditch. And then when you play a Climax, you return this card to your hand and give a character 2K. Really important with our level one, because, you know, we want to win board because we're a board focused deck. And this is also our early play condition. So on top of being hand filter as an old deck and like a one card dig, we're also like synergizing with our level one. So we definitely run four of it. It's also, again, our early play condition.
This card's going to be insane when Railgun gets its new standby support. I
Jesus
can't wait.
Christ, do not give Railgun standby. One of those, right?
I don't know. No idea.
We got this Ui. It is a brainstorm. When you play a Climax, you choose one of your characters, give it plus one level and 500 power. It is a self-rest search brainstorm. Power up set card. This is like literally your only deck speed. So you play four of it because sometimes you're going to have to like just play this card frivolously and like tap it down just to get through your deck. It happens. You're an old deck, so you do what you got to do. But in terms of a brainstorm, as it stands, this is pretty good. It helps you get over like bombs and stuff, which like at the time were like a big thing. But the fact that like you give an extra power when you play the Stock Soul is like pretty cool because you can like summon a card and stuff like that. You can like change your sequencing. Doesn't pick on your first turn if you summon it, but otherwise it's still pretty good. So differing from the June list, I play two Takitsubo because I think Takitsubo is too strong to not play. So this is the original Takitsubo. You pay one, block the top card of your deck, and you rest this and you search your library for an ESP character. So basically every relevant character that you'd want to search at that level. Again, original Takitsubo, it's just a repeatable plus. This card is really strong, even to this day, and in an old set shines even more. You got to be careful. Yeah. Sometimes you'll overplus with an effect like this, but in terms of like successive level zero turns, this card's pretty important.
It's just like a repeatable Ricky. I don't know why you wouldn't run it.
Yeah.
Seems like a no-brainer.
Yeah.
Especially if you need yellow fix, like you were saying earlier.
Mm-hmm. You need a fix for the counter, which we'll talk about pretty soon. Because the counter is yellow, but it's an event counter. So you want to be
It's all starting to come back now. I'm starting to remember. Uh-huh.
One drop search. This card has traitless tax. It searches traitless or ESP. So it searches every character in your deck. But it's only 2K instead of 2-5 because this game sucks. So yeah, you play Lolly Teacher.
Last level teacher?
Yeah, she's a teacher. Index is really weird. I don't know what to tell you.
Okay. It's anime, makes sense.
Last level zero, we play this Misaka level zero. Brainstorm, spammable, pay one, flip top four. For every character climax you hit, use a cost zero in your opponent's front row and kill it. So it's both a like deck control tool in terms of a spammable brainstorm and also just kills your opponent's characters. So you get direct lane. This card also comes in SP, which is why I play it as a one of, because, you know, it can like sometimes kill your opponent's characters against like slime, you like just like nuke your opponent's Shizus. They don't get to get their, you know, reverse effect, which is pretty funny.
And that'd be pretty dope. Meta.
Yeah, it's hilarious. But you know, it's
that'd be pretty handsome SP. Do you own the SP?
Yeah, I do. I do have the SP. Nice. But yeah, it's just like a deck control out. That's why you play it as a one of. You have like decent enough selectivity to like get it when you need it to like nuke yourself out of a deck, because you like normally have enough stock to get yourself out of a bad deck state. So that's why you play it, especially because you're playing door.
Yeah, I like tech cards like that fill kind of two roles, kill two birds with one stone. You know, it's a way to just get through your deck and fix your hand.
Two boards with one coin.
Yeah, got him. Or you can just kill your opponent's shit. That's really nice.
Yeah, level one combo. We got this Misaka from the trial deck, or not power up set, not trial deck. Two or more other ESP characters plus 1,000, so it's 5,500. And then whenever you play the stock soul, if you have five or fewer cards in stock, you choose a costier from your waiting room and summon it to any slot on stage. Doesn't even have to be an empty slot. So it's an on play plus one. Typically, you're going to summon your revenge killer to the back row or an additional attacker for a level one. So there's a little bit of finesse required with this card, where to truly plus with it, you have to summon into an empty slot. It is a real plus, and you gain value in Railgun by like winning field with costless characters. The fact that you're summoning a character to field, typically the card that we'll talk about next, which is 6,500 cross turn, you're trying to like win field with your like revenge power in at least one to two lanes. So the fact that this card is also 5,500 is really important. And of course, you're generating stock, which like back in the time when this deck was in its heyday, was like really important, because you have like an overhead for early plays and stuff like that from power upset.
So yeah, just like stock used to be really good.
So just like typical plusing combo on stock soul play.
Totally typical.
The card that you'll typically summon if you're not in a specific matchup will be this card, which is for each of your opponent's back rows, plus 500 power, so 6-5. And then when it becomes reverse, you can't use Encore in any of your lanes. So it's just a 1-0-6-5. Combined with our backups and things like that, it's going to hit 8-5-9-5-9K-10K sometimes as a costless character. So that's how we're going to win field. This is like our go-to like sort of beater that we want to summon because it's a costless character. And like its downsides aren't that big of a deal. So we want to use it in conjunction with our level one combo to just sort of summon a big costless card. And then sort of feeding into that is our revenge killer. So whenever our other character becomes reversed on either turn, we give any of our characters, because they're all ESP or Satin, except for our Kamijo, which is our level three, which I'll get into in a bit here. We give any of those characters that aren't that card 1,500 power. And then we can pay to rest it and salvage a character, but also has a plussing effect. And the fact that we summon this card for free means that like we plus this card, and then on our following turn, we can pay to rest with the stock soul. So it's sort of like a pay one plus, play bond selective plus, in a way, which, you know, at one point was really, really good. Not that great nowadays, because the meta is sped up a little bit, but the revenge power is really important for ensuring we win one to two lane on defense. But yeah, card's really important. And notably, can only buff other. So if like you summon to this to the front row and attack, it can't buff itself. A little bit more of a situational card. We have the milk truck, this 1-0-5K. We run two of it.
Oh yeah.
If you have two or more other judgment characters, which is most of the characters in your deck, it's any character with Kuroko on it. It gets on reverse, as long as you're reversal level one, you can blind stock. Stock's really at a premium in this deck because of the early play and also like brainstorm and also the pay to salvage and things like that. So if you can back this card up with like in combination with the revenge trigger and things like that, you can generate a lot of stock even on your opponent's turn. So you want to resolve this in matchups where you know that you're going to be able to get it. And it's also a costless character. So even if you don't have green level one, you can summon it off of your combo. So you can get this card out and like kill your opponent's like shitter level one, like a leftover combo. Okay.
That was going to be my big question. I'm like, how the hell are you resolving this card? You have like so little green in this deck.
Yeah, because you can just rip it out because it's a cost zero card.
I see.
Like throw it out there. But the real linchpin to level one, Dragon Counter, only three of it, because having multiples of this card in your hand feels like shit. You choose one of your characters and sack it, the 1-0 sack counter, and then choose one of your characters, and that character gets plus two levels in 2,000 power. So it's a costless plus two level 2,000 power counter. And you don't have to buff the character that's being attacked. You can be as tricky as you you want with this card. So a lot of utility, a lot of abilities to just like randomly cuck your opponent, for lack of a better term. So you can really just like get in there and screw over your opponent's on reverse stuff and things like that. Get over your opponent's lanes in combination with your revenge trigger. Have a lot of ways to screw with your opponent's attack step. If you're playing,
you can maybe like mess up a side attack if they're trying to like go for a side attack in another lane.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know.
A lot of utility.
Yeah, there's like a lot you could do with this. It's a really annoying card to play against.
Yeah, the only weird thing is that this card is yellow and that your level one is red. So if you don't have like a two color level one, you don't have anything set, you kind of get screwed because you have like red level ones, green level ones, and yellow level ones. So you're playing like a tri-color level one.
It's a party.
Yeah, I mean, it's strong enough so you make those concessions, but you know.
You probably just want to level yellow like as quick as possible, I bet, right?
Yeah, because like, you want to have that option open. You want to have that option open because then your opponent has to play around on it. Because if you're playing into Railgun, you're playing into this card. So you have to know and account for that while you're doing your attack step. To supplement that, because again, multiples of this card in your hand feel pretty bad, we're going to play two Ice Cream Counter. So this is a scalable counter. These things aren't common anymore. So it's an 1,000 power counter. And then when you use the backup, as long as you have two or more other ESP characters, it gets a 500 power times your current level. So it's either a 1,500, a 2K, or a 2.5 as costless. So it scales throughout the game. And like compared to the Dragon Counter, the fact that you can salvage this, the fact that it scales throughout the game, it's just a lot better of a card to have in your hand versus like multiples of Dragon Counter. Because a lot of people just play like four Dragon Counter and they call it a day. But I think splitting it like 3 and 5, since you're such a board-based deck and you definitely want to like win field all the time on defense, that like having 5 counters and like having a character that you can get when you trigger door is like pretty important. So I split them 3 and 2.
Sometimes 2,000 power is just not enough. So that's when you hit him with Tomboy Misaka. Or you know, sometimes 2,000 power is too much. You know, you only need 1,500 and you get him with Tomboy Misaka.
Shout out to you for that advice.
The possibilities are, you know, endless. As long as it's between 1,500 and 2,500 power.
I was sitting in Card Tower in Tokyo and Yue was like, 4 Dragon Counter feels kind of shit. Maybe you should run more Ice Cream Counter. And I was like, damn, Yue, you're right. And I've never changed my splits since.
That was an inspirational story, Carmen.
Damn, I got him. Our only level 2 in the deck is this Accelerator. If you ram him into a level 3 or higher, he's a 11-5 2 soul. Doesn't really fucking matter, but it's a way to get an extra soul damage.
I mean, I like this profile, actually. Madoka has the same card, actually. And anytime you can get 2 soul for 1 stock.
Yeah, I mean...
And also do something else meaningful, like, you know, clearing a opponent's level 3 is. Like,
I'm all about it. You have, like, field deletion, so you can, like, set up your soul however you want. But, like, the effect is a lot better than normal, I think. Because you can, like, call your shots beforehand. Speaking of calling your shot, we have the early play. The one that people know when they play into Railgun. So as long as the level 0 Kuroko, and I'll pop to that slide real quick, the one where she's wearing this like X bikini, is in your clock, this card can early play.
The X bikini.
Yeah. So long as that card's in your clock, you get to early play this. It doesn't have any on play ability, but whenever the door is placed in your climax zone, and as long as this card's in your front row, you can discard a card or a character, and it has to be a character. Then you reveal your top. As long as it's a character that's either traitless or ESP, which is every character in your deck, you choose any character in your opponent's front row, level 3 or lower, and you kill it. And then if the character that you revealed, as long as you revealed a character, rather, you kill a card in their back row that's level 2 or lower. So you just get to, like, kill a line on their field. So it's like a field nuke, which is an ability that, like, doesn't exist anymore. Like, this sort of, like, field hate. And this is the kind of ability that, like, I know June is, like, infamous for, like, winning off this effect and stuff like that, because, like, it has positive damage economy. If you're, like, opponent's out, you're, like, swinging for 4 because you, like, remove a lane before attacks and things like that, like, swinging for bigger numbers. And then, like, again, you're, like, hurting on your opponent's back row. So, like, they lose cards they're not prepared to lose unless they, like, are playing into Railgun effectively. But, like, your opponent has to play around this card at the bare minimum. And, you know, at worst, they just, like, lose their shit and, like, eat 4 damage pretty bad. And then it also has damage scry. So it's not only proactive in killing your opponent's field, but also reactive in, like, helping you cancel damage. But, like, at the time where this card came out, this card was, like, unbelievably broken. But, like, now it's, like, just pretty good. good and kind of anti-meta. Is that all we got?
Huh?
Is that all we got?
Wait, is that the end of the video?
No.
Oh, no, keep going. You're doing good. You're doing great. Keep it up. Gone Burrow.
Moving on, we got Misakuro. This card used to be on the ban list.
Really?
Yeah, this card used to be limited to two. It's literally on play or on change heal.
Limit to two.
And then on attack, pay one, ditch one, gain 2k on reverse burn one. This card used to be banned for how strong it was.
And then it's what? Is it limited to two now?
No, it's unrestricted completely. I only play two because I don't have space for more. But card's good. Misakuro is a good card, but it's not as good as it used to be. It's our only healer. I would like to play more, but like don't have space for it in the modern deck. You can make some cuts for it, I guess. You play like less Toma, less Restander, less Auxiliary. Play more of this card. It's definitely a good card, but you know, it's your off finisher or your primary finisher. You don't have a real finisher in Railgun, but you do have this promo. You got Toma, also known as My Son. He's 3/2, my beautiful boy.
He's got three souls.
He has three souls, but he also has -3 level on stage. He's a 3/2 12k who's a level 0 on stage. That's flavor if you've ever like read or watched any index or railgun. And then on attack, you can discard any card to gain one soul. Choose one of your characters and give it a soul, including himself, so he can do weird side attack shenanigans. And then on the turn that he's placed, or any turn, wait, was it? No, the turn that he's placed, he has cancel burn. So he's a 3-soul cancel burn, level 0, ditch a card, pump a soul. So he has some like crazy side attack shenanigans that he can set up, and he's my son. Don't talk to me or my son ever again. But you can talk to Satin, who is our restander. We only play one because we want to play a fancy tech card. You cannot play the fancy tech card, and you can play two of this. But up to once per turn, on the turn that you play it, as long as your character in the center attacks, when that card attacks, you can pay two, ditch two, and rest one of your standing characters that's traitless or ESP. You can stand this back up. So it's a pay two, ditch two, rest a character, restand. And then on attack, you can give one of your characters 2k.
She gets knocked down, but she gets up again.
Yeah, she gets knocked down, but she gets up again.
Nothing's gonna keep her down.
Never gonna keep her down. She gets knocked down, she gets up again. Ain't never gonna keep her down.
Yep.
And this card, Nico hates this card because of one time I played against him and I fucked him. He was playing Goblin Slayer. Five or more cards in stock. This gains 1,000 power, so it's 11k. And then the character opposite this gets -1 stole, defensive effect. And then when you play it, you can pay one and it gains 1,000 power and your opponent can't play any events until the end of their next turn. And that's why Nico hates me, because he was playing Goblin Slayer.
You just pay one on play?
Yeah. He couldn't mill out and he couldn't play what's it called, Resurrection, on the same turn. Pretty cool.
Thanks, Satan at it again.
I have this card next.
Satan.
I have this card in SP. That's the only reason I play it.
Dude, when I watched Railgun for the first time and I was reading the subtitles, I thought her name was Satan. I'm like,
Hail Satan.
She doesn't seem that evil, you know, like she seems like a nice girl. Why are they calling her that?
Dark Soul Door. You know, it's not the best, but it's what we got. We deal with it. And here's the whole deck list again. You know, we do what we can. We do one thing. We deny reverses and we get big.
We try to
win with costless characters. We kill our opponent's back row. We heal sometimes. We cancel burn sometimes. We restand other times. We have enough like selectivity to do the right thing in the right matchup. So it is what it is. If you play this deck into your modern locals, you're going to have a rough time, but you'll have a fun time. This deck is never not entertaining. If you want to play an old deck and you like the rail deck series and stuff like that, I definitely wouldn't discourage anyone from picking it up, because you can just sort of get people with them, as Andy likes to say. You can really get people with railgun. Yeah, I've
gotten got by this.
Yeah, it's definitely
every time I sit down against it.
It's definitely a gotcha deck.
It's definitely a getter.
Yeah, you can
if you like to get them.
You can definitely get them with railgun.
In the mood to go to locals and you just want to get them, yeah, play railgun. Yeah. By the way, the art on these cards is absolutely fantastic. Like,
I've never
really like actually looked at these cards like in depth, but like they're handsome cards.
Railgun has some really cool art. Big fan. Rail decks, index, railgun, whatever you want to call it. Art's pretty handsome. So if you like the series and you want to play the deck, it's definitely not like bad enough to where I wouldn't take it to locals. It's definitely competent enough to play at a local level. So crack it out, have some fun.
Get
them. Nuke your opponent's back row. Get them with your backups. You'll play Dragon Counter and they'll be like, what the fuck? And then they'll lose the game. And it'll be really funny. And while you're at it, you can join the card games and competitive Whiteboards Discord if you want to play some games. Talk about White. Global community, NA community, if you want to buy, sell, trade, or see some JP like spoilers and stuff like that. And then all our Twitters for all of our our recurring guest. Andy, you got anything else on our way out?
No, not really. See you next time. Bye! Yeah.